Good morning, saints of God. Why, praise the Lord. Here it is, another glorious Monday morning. And boy, we had a great weekend. And it just seems like every week now, my weekends are just jam full, busy, busy, busy. What a busy day we had yesterday and a great day here at the house of God. Preached on the rapture of the church yesterday. And I'm telling you, I'm looking for Jesus Christ to come and come soon. And thank the Lord for that truth, that we know that Jesus Christ is soon to return to the planet Earth and take us home. Won't that be great? And the great wedding will begin, and we'll have the marriage feast of the Lamb. And boy, it will be great. And then last night, as you all would remember, we talked about King Jesus, okay? His kingdom authority, his kingdom power, his kingdom agenda, and, his kingdom, and also his kingdoms, his kingly proclamations. And, it was a good night in God's house, and we thank the Lord for that as well. So we're looking at a new work week starting today, tomorrow being food bank, and once again, we're back in the cycle again to see how things go. And as we've kind of been pushing through, we went through the book of Colossians a little bit. I know I didn't go verse by verse with you, but I kind of read through there, and if you go through the book of Colossians, the next book you read naturally would be the book of Thessalonians. So let's kind of look here, and I was reading through here today, and something just caught my eye that I really wanted to share with you. You know, in chapter number one, Paul identifies himself and who he is and the why he's writing and everything. And in verse number two, he comes and he talks about giving thanks and always for him, how close he was to these people. And he's constantly mentioning them in prayer. And so he's praying back and forth for them. But when you come to 1 Thessalonians chapter number one, and you look at verse number three, and let Heather put it here on the screens for me right here. He says, remember without ceasing your work of faith. Underline that, work of faith. And labor of love. Underline that in your Bible. And patience of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ and in the sight of God and our Father. You know, Paul's writing here to this church. He's remembering some things about them, and it's going to be a precious letter. We're going to look at some things here and see kind of the next couple of weeks what the Lord has through us as we go through the book of Thessalonians. And, it's wonderful that these people had what I would call balance in their Christian faith. They're not often one extreme, often another extreme. Why? There's balance in their Christian faith. And I think it's an amazing thing, as you see here, balance. You know, I got Miss Sherry a bike for Christmas. And, they say you never forget how to ride a bike. Well, let me just tell you something. When you're 60 years old, things kind of change, and you haven't ridden a bike in, 30 years. And so, getting on the bike and getting all those things. And she's been pretty good about riding her bike, and she's getting in shape. And it's fun. But that I got on that bike, and that thing about balancing, I guess what it is this day and age, I just got more to balance than what I ever had before. And, it's just kind of a little bit challenging right at the very beginning when you get back to riding a bike like that. But I'm going to tell you something. You can't go on your bike. You can't move forward on your bike unless there's some balance in your ride. And probably one time we'll have to have somebody video it so we can have a funny video for church when I'm riding the bike. But as I think about your life is the same way. You need to have balance. And these were the people of Thessalonica. They had balance. They had a work of faith. They were not afraid to work. You know, we live in a day and age where people only get paid $15 an hour for doing nothing. They don't want to work. Work is a good word. Work is healthy. But their work was a work of faith. And not only was it a work of sweat and toils and tears, but it was also a faith work. It was trusting God to provide each step of the way, each day along the journey. You know, I'm going to tell you something. I believe God, well, we know it's the truth. It's whether we believe it or not. The truth of the matter is that the just shall live by faith. And you and I are challenged in this day and age to work by faith. You know, we don't see tomorrow. We don't see even the future later on today. And sometimes we get so busy doing the things of God that we wonder in our minds, does this really matter? You know, if I'm faithful to the house of God, or if I'm faithful in my preaching, if I'm faithful in my Bible devotion, does it really matter? Well, you know, that's one of those things that comes out by faith, and we have to learn to trust the Lord by faith and do those things by faith. Then the next thing was their labor of love. Not only did they work of faith, but they labored in love. I mean, their motivation for doing what they did was not a pat on the back. Their motivation was not to be to win the game, to have the most toys. Their motivation in life was love for people, but more importantly, something that supersedes that is a love for the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, they labored out of a love for him. You know, would to God today we could get the church to fall in love with Jesus Christ, who he is, his glory, his wonder, and the love that he has for us. I want to tell you something, folks. You know, I realize Jesus Christ is my Savior. I realize that Jesus Christ is my Master. But I want to tell you something. Jesus Christ is the friend that sticketh closer than a brother. Jesus Christ is the dearest friend. And, if we could have a relationship that is cemented around those kind of thoughts in our hearts and life. And then he says, patience of hope. Why? They never let the problems, the trials, the situation to bury them. They had that hope, that hope that God had given some promises to them, and that hope carried them through the trials of life. And that hope is what would inspire them. That hope encouraged them. And folks, I really believe if we're going to have a ministry that counts for anything, we need to have a work of faith, we need to have a labor of love, and we need to have a patience of hope. I think those are three things that we really need. Just right off the top of the opening the book of 1 Thessalonians and reading through there, you see some things that we really need to have in our life. Now, here's the deal. Nobody has all three of those things worked out to the max. You and I need to work on those three areas of our life, that we develop some good balance, and that we can glorify the Lord Jesus Christ in our walk and through our day. All right? Just want to challenge you on that thought. I think it's a precious verse, and it's definitely what we need to have in our lives. All right? Let's have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, once again, we do thank you for your goodness to us. Thank you, Father, for the example that the Lord Jesus Christ ran for us. Lord, help us to be, as Paul mentioned in the book of Hebrews, to looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, Father. May we see him as our example all along the way. May we, Father, run with our eyes focused on the cross. Father, we do love you and thank you now, and we pray that you bless this week. Father, may it be a great week. Father, may people get saved because of our testimonies this week. May we draw closer to you. And we pray, Lord, that even that this may be the week that you come and take us home. Thank you for all you're going to do. Be with these that are sick. Be with Bill Cantor and the surgery that he's facing today. For we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you. God bless you. Go serve your King. Bye-bye.